Hello and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Che. Today, we're welcoming back to the show our friend, musician Nate Wong. He may be best known as the founder and drummer of the popular band Nowhere Boys and for performing with Cantopop stars such as Sammi Cheng and Hacken. He's also an accomplished jazz and funk musician. Apart from Nowhere Boys, Nate is also involved in two other bands, Wong Way Down and Good Funk Shui. He's here with Good Funk Shui to talk about a new album that he's been working on for the past 3 years. Gerald, Christy, Nate, members of Good Funk Shui, welcome to The Works.
Welcome. I mean, not welcome. Welcome you guys. I'm happy to be here.
It's good to have you back. So let's start by talking about the band Good Funk Shui. What was the sort of original idea or inspiration behind it?
Yeah, actually, it's not the sexiest answer, but it's kind of a COVID situation. Like, before COVID, I was, like, touring all over. I was, like, doing my session things. I was doing all that work, and I never really had time to do anything other than what I was doing. Mm. But since it was that big pause, I was at home, and I was, like, started to write different kinds of music and experiment with different, like, sides of my own musicality. So actually, this project, which is not that new now, it's, like, 3 years old now, is the first time that I wrote songs with lyrics, with stories, and it's the first time I, like, attempted to sing. Like, literally, like, not attempted to sing in public, like, attempted to sing ever. So that's how it came about.
Right. Well, let's talk about the members. I mean, it seems like there are many people in it. Gerald, Christy, you guys are part of the group. How mm-hmm. did the members all come together?
Well, actually, Gerald, I would say, I haven't really even said this to him, but he played a really, really big part in this band in that he kind of introduced some music to me that is kind of like in this style, okay? So, like, one of them is artist called Theo Katzman, another one's called Lawrence, and they're, like, funky music with good storytelling. And that resonated with me hugely because I've always listened to funky music, and I've listened to music with good storytelling, and it's like when I heard the combination, I realized, like, oh, this is something I can do. So Gerald, I met 3 years ago around, and he came back from UK, and he, like, came in the Hong Kong scene, and he's, like, a fantastic piano player, like, like really, really good at jazz and pop and everything. And so he's been in the band since the ground level. Mm. And then Christy, I met only last year, and we were, like, out in the jam sessions in Hong Kong. It's a great place to meet people and, like, expand your musical horizons. And she's actually, you mind if I say your age? She's actually only 22 years old, you guys. And she's, like, extremely talented. And, yeah, I mean, the story really is that she came to these jam sessions and, like, didn't really know that much about, like, jamming or, like, improvising, right?
I wasn't, like, singing or gigging. I was just, like, singing in my room. Right. But then they heard me sing and they're like, oh, you should come more and, like, try to jam more. And so that summer, I just kept going. Right. And then they were, like, teaching me songs to sing. So I was kind of, like, groomed. And then after a year, they're like, oh, this is, like, you're at a pretty good level now.
And you're part of the band then.
Yeah, and then he asked me to.
Yeah, totally.
Cool. Well, so the band Good Funk Shui released an album recently, Good Funk Shui.
Yes.
So let's talk about the album. It took 3 years to create many, many changes.
Yes.
Tell us more about it.
Yeah, so it. I started writing it at the beginning of COVID, and then I eventually got the 8 songs, and then I planned to release it that summer, which is the summer of 2020. That's when I planned to release it. And there's a version of the album where it's just me singing all the songs, and it was like, I just wanted to put that out. It's like, oh, this is me singing my first songs. But then I'm, like, listening to the album. It's like me singing. It's like I'm not the best singer. And I didn't know what to do. And actually, at that time, I considered even singing in the band. But then I was like, no. It's like making the singing is terrible. It's making my drumming terrible, too. So then I got, like, somebody to sing in the band. It was, like, definitely the right choice. So before Christy, there was a singer named Megan. And she's from South Africa, and she sang in the band for about a year, and she's, like, so great. But then, you know, like, it's a story of many people in Hong Kong or many situations. Like, she actually ended up deciding to leave.
Right.
So she moved back to South Africa, and then I was, like, for a while singerless. And then I found Christy to be in the band. And then, like, when I heard her sing in the band, I was like, oh, no. Like, she actually has to be on the album, too. Right. So then she sang on the album, and in a way, it's a blessing it took this long for the album to be put out. Because had I put it out in the summer of 2020, it would have been that album. Which would have been, like, okay, but not really the thing.
Very cool. Well, let's talk about the band itself. So I know you have a rotating cast of members or people who play different instruments. Mm-hmm. Tell us how it all works.
Yeah, well, ideally, it wouldn't be rotating. Mm-hmm. Actually, ideally, it would be in the same band. But because I use, like, literally the best musicians mm-hmm. in Hong Kong, or the best musicians that are my friends, I should say, because they're the best, they're really busy. And mm-hmm. sometimes I have to rotate the members. But the good thing about that is that it's actually expanded our collective. Oh. So now not only is it the six people you see, we actually sometimes have horn players. So if you saw us at the Free Space Jazz Festival, we had two horn players too. And then over the years, there's been different guitar players, and they all contribute their own style to mm-hmm. the band. And you know, so on and so forth. And so the band actually to this day, to me, is much bigger than six people. There's probably about 20 people where I consider family. Part of the concept of the album is just to get all my friends on it. And it's so much fun for me to listen to the album. It's like I just listen to like all my friends play, like one by one. And there's a little bit of a country music aspect to this album. And like I used to live in Arkansas. So I had my friend play a little guitar from Arkansas. There's a couple people from New York, like really good New York saxophone players, so there's a really jazzy aspect of the album. A couple friends from New York, Clay Lyons, Nate Anderson, and a lot of people from Hong Kong. T-Jo, who's been on this show, is on the album. Some of the songs have Hong Kong themes, like one of the ones today. Although, are they really Hong Kong themes? Because you take this theme and you put it in another city, it still works.
Can you elaborate a bit more when you say there are Hong Kong themes on the songs?
Well, there's that one song, Taxi Driver. Mm-hmm. And admittedly, now thinking about it, the taxi could be anywhere.
Could be anywhere. That's...
But it was inspired by a Hong Kong taxi experience.
Exactly.
And if you listen to the album, you actually have local taxi drivers speaking on the track.
Very cool.
When I made the... finish the track, there's all these like long instrumental funky sections on it, and I was like, what should we put on there? Like Natural Choices put a solo on it, but I was like, there's enough of that. So then I was like I should interview taxi drivers around Hong Kong and see what they have to say about like driving taxis. I actually had two questions for them. One was like, what's your favorite part about driving taxi? And the other one was like, what's your advice to young people in Hong Kong? So I for a few weeks, like every time I got in a taxi, I would like interview taxi drivers like with my phone, like ask them this question. So actually, those are on the album.
You're here with a few other members as well, and you guys, I believe, will hear a track. Which song have you chosen to perform today?
We're gonna do the aforementioned Taxi Driver.
Very nice.
Taxi driver, he pulls up at the curb, he's smooth around the curves, his window's down, his radio's up, he's listening to a song that goes like la 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 la. I wish you good luck with the taxi driver. Good luck with the taxi driver. He'll make sure you're on time. He drives in a straight line. His window's down, his radio's up. He's listening to a song that goes like la 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 la. Hey. With the taxi driver, he lets you have a snack. His seat's not too far back. His window's down, his radio's up. He's listening to a song that goes like la 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 la. A stop, drop, hail a cab. It's the best kind of ride, but when you're happy, you're sad. Stop, drop, taxi driver. And even if you're drunk, you put on some good funk. His window's down, his radio's up, he's listening to a song that goes like la 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 la.
Welcome back. Before we continue with the second half of the interview with Good Funk Shui and hear an additional song from the band, we're going to take a journey into nature. That's the title of the latest exhibition by sculptor and installation artist Ming Fay at Alisan Fine Arts. Some viewers may recognize some of the works on show. The exhibition is in part an expansion of the large-scale installation Garden of Life that was presented at the most recent Art Basel Hong Kong. As well as his iconic larger-than-life fruits, nuts, and vegetables, the exhibition includes works from his Tai Chi figure and wishbone series and some early sketches. I have to ask you guys, so going back to the title, Good Feng Shui or Good Feng Shui,
yep.
What does that mean in relation to this album?
Yeah, so the band name is Good Funk Shui because I hope to bring you good feng shui to your listening environment through funk music.
Okay.
The album is literally called Good Funk Shui or Good Feng Shui. No pun in the album title. because... Yeah, same reason. You know, it's supposed to, like, when you listen to it, it's supposed to increase the feng shui. And actually, it's not one of those, it's a very long album. The tracks are very long. I want you to just, like, put it on and, like, chill, let it, like, be all over the room, and that's it, you know? That's just, it's kind of a good vibes album. But had it not taken those 2.5 years, we would have not gotten to this right. version of the album. So I'm actually super happy it took this long. It took the right amount of time. And actually, the album that I put out is, like, remarkably similar to what I had in mind. 3 years ago. So I'm like completely happy with it, which is crazy. It's crazy. It's really hard to put out your own stuff and not hold on to like all these like insecurities about it. Actually, I struggled with this album. Like you might know I'm like Nowhere Boys and stuff, and that band's put out like 5-6 albums in the time that I put in it. And this album took me so long because it's like I wrote it and it's like I'm pretty good at not being a perfectionist. I'm good at producing stuff, but for this one, I got caught up a little bit, and it's cool. It's good to understand like why people get caught up in their own stuff, but then I eventually got it out, so that's an accomplishment.
Very cool. And you guys have already had the actual album release party. Well, going forward, will there be plans for a tour? What do you hope to do with this album and the band?
Yeah, I mean, in December, we're playing several times around Hong Kong, so you can look at our schedule for that. Going into the future, I really hope to travel with this band around Asia. I really think that the music kind of represents Hong Kong in a way.
Well, you're here with other band members today and would love to hear a song. Which tune would you like to play for us today?
Sure. I'd like to share this tune called Do You, okay, because I think one of the biggest challenges in life is like when you're in some kind of relationship or work situation or any kind of life situation and you have to go from that situation to leaving it, right? But then you have to leave all these people and all these things. And sometimes you don't get a chance to say everything you wanted to say to that person before you left. And that happened to me. And the thing I really wanted to say to that person was that they should just do you, like keep being yourselves. And even though like maybe our journey down this road is separating, if we both like do you, be ourselves, we'll do good, we'll do fine. And this is like the message I wanted to deliver through the song, so this one's called Do You.
Awesome. Well, once again, thank you very much for coming in today, and I look forward to hearing the song.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Didn't have the wisdom to know good from bad. In 2017, I got the Tinder app. At last, I realized that I'm a four at best. If I could, I wouldn't change a thing. All my mistakes stay. If I could, I wouldn't make a stay. It hurts my didn't go my way. It hurts my heart to say that you should go and do 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 you. It hurts my heart to say that you should go and do 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 you. That didn't go my way, but you should go and do. In future, I will try to be relaxed. In fact, I'm quitting coffee, cigarettes, and I'm laying off snacks. If I could, I wouldn't make a thing. All my mistakes stay. If I could, I wouldn't make a stay. It hurts my heart to say. That didn't go my way. It hurts my heart to say that you should.